So in the last class we were talking about the constant K type of filter, also known as monotype type of filter. Okay, and we have derived a formula for low pass, high pass, band pass and band reject filter. In the last I have told you the drawback, that is the attenuation is not sharp, and to overcome this attenuation we go for another type of filter which is known as amp derived filters. Now what happens, first of all we will derive the generalized formula for the amp type filters both in T configuration and in pi configuration, in the sense that in previously constant K type of filters, T, what was the shape configuration of T type filters? There was a inductor and a, there is a series arm consisting of Z1 by 2. That is, inductor was L by 2. Is it clear? And the shunt arm consists of a capacitor having value C. Similarly, pi configuration was there. The shunt arm consists of twice twice of Z2. And the series arm consists of simply
Z.
Now this will change. This will change. But and how will you derive it? By taking into consideration that whether it is an M derived or constant type filter, the characteristic impedance will remain same. What I am saying, whether it is a M type filter or M derived filter or constant K filter, the overall characteristic impedance of the filter will remain. That was what was in case of T configuration for a constant, for a constant K filter. What was characteristic impedance formula? Under root
Z2
square by 4 plus Z2 into duality. Okay, this formula you have to apply. Now, what is M derived filter? I am giving you the formula. First of all, we will take pi, sorry, T configuration. T configuration will take, will derive everything for the T configuration. Now what happens, as the name suggests, a coefficient M is attached. A coefficient M is attached. Now let's say my new impedance is in T configuration is Z1 dash. Previously it was Z1 and Z2. Now let it be Z1 dash, such that Z1 dash is equal to M Z1. Such that Z1 dash is M Z1, where M is a coefficient. Okay. Now, therefore, definitely Z1 has changed. Therefore, Z2 will also change. Is it clear? Let it be Z2 dash. Let it be Z2 dash. Now we have to evaluate Z2 dash in terms of M. We have to evaluate Z2 dash in terms of M. Okay. So what is the formula we will use? What is the condition we will use? That the characteristic impedance in the basic configuration of T and the characteristic impedance in this derived configuration will remain same. What was the characteristic impedance in basic configuration Z2 T?
Under root
Z1 square upon 4 plus Z1 into Z2 duality. This was the characteristic impedance in basic configuration. Now let it be ZOT dash. What will happen in this? It should be as per Z1 dash and Z2 dash. Do you agree? Do you agree or not?
Yes, sir.
Now what I have told you, that in both configurations, either derived or prototype, ZOT must be equal to ZOT.
Yes.
Clear? Okay, now equating both the both formula, what you will get? Z1 square by 4 plus Z1 into Z2 should be equal to
Z1 dash
square. Z1 dash square. In Z1 dash. This should be equal to Z1 dash square by 4 plus Z1 dash into Z2 dash. Do you agree?
Yes, sir.
Now what is Z1? Z1 dash? M Z1 substitute it and try to express Z2 in terms of Z1 is Z2 dash. Try to express Z2 dash in terms of Z1 and
Z2.
We will replace Z1 dash by whom?
Z1.
Replace it. Derived T configuration. Assumption. Rash thing is same. What is rash thing is same? Suppose I say now you have to design a high pass, some low pass filter first of all. Then again, what will you do? Z1 and Z2 are same. Z1 will become inductor and Z2 will become a capacitor. Is it clear? But the configuration will have this one. How you select the value of M? Is it clear? So accordingly it will become M times L1 by 2. It will become M L1 by 2. And what will you begin?
MC.
And what is there? It is used to be capacitor. Okay. In capacitors, what is the impedance of capacitor? J of 1 minus J of 1 omega C. Is it clear? And here also M is coming in denominator. C is also coming in denominator. So value of capacitor will be equal to how much? And volume of inductor? 1 minus m square upon 4m into L1 or L. It is Z1. It is Z1. Z1 is what in your low pass filter? Inductor. So it is L. You got my point over. So don't get confused. What is the main mistake being done by the student? They get confused in putting the value of capacitor as an inductor. In inductor, the formula of impedance is J omega L. So if you are choosing L bar, if you are choosing MZ1, then it will begin J omega ML. Is it clear? But in case of capacitance, it is Z2 by M. Is it clear? So when you substitute, so what will be the total Z2 dash? J minus J upon, or simply 1 upon J. Capacitance impedance will be how much? Z2 dash? 1 upon J omega. Omega C multiplied by M in denominator. So net capacitance will become how much? MC. Is it clear? Don't make it C by M. This is the mistake being done by the student. Is it clear? Don't make it C by M. It will become M into C. M. With the same analogy, don't put it here because here it is inductor. What is the formula of inductor Z1? J omega L. So the net inductor will be given 1 minus m square upon 4m multiplied by n in the denominator. This is clear or not? Okay. In a similar way, this is for which configuration? M derived pi configuration. The same formula is for m derived pi configuration. Let us do this. First of all, again the same thing. What you have to do? Now, though I have told you before proceeding this, but conclusion we will draw from the same equation. Though in the beginning I have told you that the M is a coefficient whose values lie between
0
and 1. What is the physical reason, what is the logic behind it that should always lie between 0 and 1?
Because 1 minus m square is 1.
Yes.
1 minus m square.
Yes. This is well correct. Now this is a physical element. Do you agree? Z1 is a physical element. It should exist in physical form. For physical form, what should be the value? 1 minus m square should be a positive. Positive should be greater than 0. Now solve the value for m. 1 minus m square is greater than 0. Solve it. What is the value of m?
M should be less than
1.
M should be less than 1.
M should be
less than
1. You got my point or not? Is it clear? Now it should be greater than 0 also. If m is equal to 0, then this will become n. In finite open circuit, what is the meaning of this? So m should be greater than 0. Is it clear? It should not be less than 0 also. Why? And then negative impedance. No, so basic lie is that the value of M should lie between 0 and 1 in order to have a physical existence. This is clear or not? Okay, now next, now we proceed for derivation of the Z1 dash and Z2 dash for an pi configuration. Okay, first of all, the same procedure. What is the same procedure?
Z2 by pi.
Yes. The connector's impedance should remain same. In fact, the value again Z1 dash is equal to how much? M Z1. Now we have to evaluate what? Z2 dash. Now character impedance in case of Z0 pi is how much? On the it is how much in basic configuration? Z1 into Z2 upon under root Z1 square upon 4 plus Z1 into Z2. Do you remember? Now in case of denied Z0 pi dash, how much it should be? Z1 dash into Z2 dash upon Z1 square dash upon 4 plus Z1 dash into Z2. Do you agree? Are you, do you agree or not? Now, what is the condition?
Z0 pi
equal to Z0 pi. Z0 pi dash should be equal to Z0 pi. Equate both the terms, what do you get? Z2 dash is equal to M. Instead of this, we will go for this. Which one?
Z2 dash
is equal to Z2 by M. So by assuming this, what will happen? Now we will get Z1 dash in terms of
Z1.
Is it clear? So now substitute this here, what you get? Now, what happens? In books you will find a simpler method also. What they have done, that this formula is being also being reshuffled. How? Just see, can I write in this form also this formula? Just check it. Just check it. Can I write this Jacobite formula in this way also? Do you agree it is mathematically correct? If not, I can explain it. If everybody agrees, is it mathematically the same thing? Everybody agrees? Okay. Now I will utilize this for simpler, for simplification. So what is my similar Z1 will become how much? Z1 dash, Z2 dash upon 1 plus Z1 dash upon 4. What is Z2 dash? Z1
by? Z2 by.
Clear? Equate both these two because the condition state that the characteristic impedance in prototype as well as M derived should remain. Is it clear? Now when you equate this, the square root will go up. Is it not? So we are left with what? Z1 by Z2 upon 4 plus Z1 upon 4 Z2 is equal to how much?
Z1
dash multiplied by Z2 by M upon 1 plus Z1 dash by 4 Z2 by M. What you have to eliminate? You have to find out the Z1 dash in terms of
Z1,
Z1, Z2. Is it clear? So when you will reshuffle it at your reshuffle it.
Yes.
What you get?
And Z2, Z2.
Now, while reshuffling, see what happens. When you reshuffle it and rearrange it, you will get Z1 dash is equal to, I am just writing out. Which are connected in parallel. The value of one is value of second is 4 f upon 1 minus f square. You got my point or not? So the idea of choosing z2 by m was that you get a singular value. 4 f upon 1 minus m square was there in your previous t configuration also or not?
Yes.
You agree or not? Okay. Same value, but you have to be very careful in assigning whether the numerator form or denominator. Is it clear? Previously, I think so 1 minus m square was in numerator.
Yes, sir.
Is it clear? So don't get confused. Here only the confusion point arises. Sometimes you know everything. You know that something term is there, 1 minus m square upon 4m. But you apply in the t configuration. In t configuration, it is, I think, 1 minus m square upon 4m. In pi configuration, it is
4m
upon 1 minus m square z. So that these points you have to keep in mind during the examination period. You know everything. But through confusion, you make mistake and lose marks. Is it clear? And that is only you can understand if you pay consideration. The just before the 10 minutes of the examination, you concentrate on these things. Not on the derivation, but consider on these things that in case of t configuration, it is 1 minus m square upon 4m. While in case of pi configuration, it is 4m upon 1 minus m square. Clear? So, what will be the look of the pi configuration? T configuration, I have already drawn basic type and first of all, I have drawn this basic type configuration. It will be twice Z2 in shunt series consisting of Z1 and again a shunt arm consisting of twice Z2. Do you agree?
Yes, sir.
Do you agree or not? Now what is change? May I help you solve this? See, now I have assumed Z2 dash as a, here what I will get? Twice Z2 dash. Here I will get Z1 dash. But I have to express in terms of Z1 and Z2. Is it clear? So what I have assumed Z2?
Z2 by
M. So what I will get here? Twice Z2 by M. Do you agree? Are you agree or not? Similarly, I have in shunt arm here also value consisting of twice Z2 by M. Now, this is consisting of Z1 2 parallel branches. One will be this, another will be this, and the connected is parallel like this. What is the value of first?
MZ1.
And what is the value of second?
4m
upon Z2 upon 1 minus
Z2.
Do you agree or not? Again, you can verify that the value of the M should lie between 0 and 1 in the same condition. Is it not? Okay, so we have verified. So this is the Z pi configuration. This is the M derived pi configuration. Now, after denoting these two general configurations, you have to again be conscious by selecting the C band. Suppose I design low pass filter, then what will become this? A low pass filter, then this will be definitely a capacitor. Z2 is what? A capacitor. And value of capacitor will be how much? MC by 2. Is it clear? Don't say it is twice C by M. It is MC by 2. Is it clear? And what about the inductor?
ML.
What about the inductor? Z1 is what? G omega, so multiply by M, it will become ML. Is it clear? What about this Z2? What is the value of capacitor as?
1
minus M square upon 4M into C. Is it clear or not? You know the basic configuration, but by substituting the value you will make mistake. These points you have to keep in mind. Everybody? Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay? So now, with this much of background, we will now derive the formula or the values of L and C for the different types of filters, which can be M derived low pass filter, M derived high pass filter, M derived band pass filter, and M derived band reject filter. Is it clear? So let us your first topic in this M derived low pass filter. Again, what is there? What is there? Now, a typical examiner will always ask for a derived filter. Why? Because prototype which you already included. Is it clear? So, if you know Z1 will be equal to how much? J omega. Z2 will be equal to how much? 1 upon J omega C. Clear? What will be the value of can you draw the now T configuration for low pass filter?
Yes.
Can you draw it?
Yes, sir.
Give me. Remember it, just see. If you are not remembering, just go through it. What was there? Z2 dash. What was there? Z2 dash in T configuration? Z2 by M. Do you clear? So Z2 by M means a capacitor, first of all, in low pass filter. Is it clear? And the value of that capacitor will be?
MC.
So this will be? Is it clear? And what about the Z1 dash? There is Z1 dash is there?
Yes,
1 minus M square upon
4M.
And what is your Z1?
L.
So it will be 1 minus M square upon 4M. Is there any problem?
No, sir.
This is the, which what is called this is? T type M derived low pass. Now, there is an important point here. What is that important point? The value of L, C, you have already calculated. You have calculated or not?
Yes, sir.
In the prototype, we know the value of L and C for low pass filter. Now, how to choose M? So that our problem, what was the problem? That there should be a sharp
addition.
Is it either designer will give or some another parameter will be given through which we design, through which we evaluate the value of M, and then we will derive the different components. So what is required? M. Now for M, the main factor is that you can write down. For designing the M, we take into consideration the resonant frequency. For designing the M, take into consideration what? This is L and this is C. Now whenever LNC is there, there is chances that they may resonate at some
frequency.
Is it clear? Now we want that in a low pass filter, this resonant frequency, that it be, it is denoted in Koch's by F infinite. It is denoted by F infinite. Now what is say that? That it should resonate at a frequency greater than cutoff frequency. It should resonate at a frequency greater than the cutoff frequency. Is it clear? Had it been resonating at below the cutoff frequency, what will happen? Just look through the code. What will happen? What will happen? Resonance of oscillation will be there. Is it there? And that oscillation are harmful for our filters. Is it clear? So in order to avoid, our resonant frequency should be such that it should be above the cutoff frequency. In low pass filter, what is there? You just imagine. In low pass filter, what is required? This is pass band. And this is your. This is pass band and this is your stop band. Okay, what is required? Now this resonant frequency should be greater than. So first of all, evaluate the resonant frequency. First of all, evaluate the resonant frequency. How to evaluate the resonant frequency? They should be equal?
Yes, sir.
What do you do in RLC in resonant circuit? You make imaginary part is equal to 0. Or in other words, XL should be equal to XC. This you have done. Same thing you do it here. Find out at what resonant, at what frequency you will resonate. Equate these two parts. That is, what is this? And what is this? This is Z2 by M. So Z2 by M should be equal to 1 minus m square upon 4m into. Just solve it, what you get. What is that one?
Omega
L. Let us think, because we are considering resonant frequency, so instead of f infinite, let's say we fr. For your convenience, let it be fr. So what you will get? How much is this? Magnitude. Remove J, take magnitude value, what you will get? 1 upon 2 pi FRC into M. This should be equal to how much? 1 minus M square upon 4M. What is that one? 2 pi FR into L. Just evaluate value of FR. Can you evaluate? Can you evaluate?
Yes, sir.
Okay, give me the result. I will see what is your mathematical attitude. Do you agree?
Yes, sir.
Everybody agrees this formula?
Yes, sir.
FR is equal to 1 upon pi under root LC. Isko main iske saath hi likh sakta hu. Bracket 1 minus m square, or separately I am writing under root 1 minus m square. This is clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now I will make one change. Okay. If you remember the formula for in the case of prototype or constant K low pass filter, what was the formula for FC? Just your pages and give me the formula for cutoff frequency fc. Everybody agrees that this was the formula for cutoff frequency for a prototype low pass filter. Now just put it here. So FR should be equal to FC upon 1 minus M square. Do you agree? Do you agree? Clear? Okay, now reshuffle it so that you obtain M in terms of FR and FC. For the M. This is the formula for M. And I have already told you that in some books this FR is not written as FR, but it is written as F infinite. This has been done so that attenuation does not take this F infinite means frequency of infinite. Frequency of infinite attenuation. Now where you require infinite attenuation? In the stop band. So you should be selective enough that your infinite frequency or the frequency of infinite attenuation should be greater than FC. Should be greater than FC. And who can cause it? Who can cause it? Resonance. So that is why F infinite is termed is also equal to FR. So in books, instead of FR, it is written as F infinite. So in question, for M derived filter, what you will be given? You will be asked design a M derived low pass filter. Design means find out the value of L and C. Is it clear? Such that the characteristic impedance is 600 ohm and its cutoff frequency is this one. So first of all, what you need to do? First of all, evaluate F with the help of the formula under root 1 minus FC. FC is what? Cutoff frequency. And F infinite is? Because of infinite attenuation. Now this should be always be greater than this. Is it clear? If we are asking a low pass filter that F infinite should be greater than? If it is not greater, it means question is wrong. Is it clear? For high pass filter, there is the opposite is there. But for low pass filter, F infinite should be greater than? You got my point or not? Clear? So, this is all about the design of the M derived low pass filter. You can write down one question also. What is the idea of M derived? I will give you some physical insight also and take from that. What is the idea of M derived filter? To have sharp attenuation. Sharp attenuation is high attenuation. Sharp means that as soon as cutoff is clear, the attenuation should be very high. This is the idea. Now in resonance. You have learned in series resonance, amplitude became
maximum.
Is it clear? This is also clear. So definitely at resonance, attenuation will be very high. Attenuation will be very high. So when designing a low pass filter, it is always kept in mind by the designer that this F infinite should be very close to F. Not equal to, but it should be very close to F5 or possibly. So that as soon as it clears the cutoff frequency, attenuation becomes high and our purpose is soft. First thing is that F infinite should be greater than F0. It is not that attenuation should take place in the past time. This is also not desirable. It should be there, but it should be after cutoff frequency. And also the cutoff frequency and F infinite are being placed very close to each other. This is clear in your mind or not? Okay, so write down one question. Design a M derived T and pi network. T and pi networks low pass filter with characteristic impedance is equal to 900 ohm. Cutoff frequency being 0.9 kHz. And infinite frequency being 1 kHz. Cutoff frequency being 0.9 kHz and infinite frequency being 1 kHz. So see, in question also, I have kept cutoff frequency how much? 0.9 kHz. And what is my infinite? Just near about 1 kHz. You got my point or not? A designer keeps the infinite frequency nearby cutoff frequency. So what you will design first of all? First of all, calculate M. What is M?
0.43.
0.43. 436?
Yes.
You got my point, everybody?
Yes.
M, just substitute F. C is equal to how much?
0.9.
And what is F infinite?
1.
Just evaluate mathematically to calculate. Comes out to be M comes out to be 0.436. With no units. Mind it, it is a coefficient. Now next after that, what you will evaluate? MZ1. MZ1 means you have to evaluate the component. M is not calculated, but you have to calculate L. L for L, what you will use? The formula, prototype formula. Okay, the prototype formula is for L. Do you remember how much it was? R naught upon phi FC. Just see, what was the formula for L? R naught upon phi FC. Am I correct?
Yes.
Go through your previous papers. Previous. Not in terms of LNC. LNC you have to evaluate. In terms of cutoff frequency, what was there? You don't have the register with you. Then go through it. What I am saying is correct or not? Just justify me.
Yes.
For low pass filter. This is L1 and C2. This is band. I am talking about low pass filter. You don't have the register of low pass filter. Okay, that is the problem. Do you have? Anybody have the register content of the low pass filter? Yes. What was the value?
R0 upon C0.
No, my dear friend, I might have given you the formula for the L in terms of R0 and FC.
R0 upon FC.
That's what I have written. Do you agree or not? This is the formula. FC you know, R0 is how much given? I think so 900 ohm. substitute it, you will get L is equal to how much?
318.3 millihenry.
Clear? What about the value of C? If you remember for a low pass filter.
Yes, sir.
Is it clear? Substitute the value, you will get the value of 0.171 microfarad. Clear? But still, the film is incomplete. Okay, it is a climax scene, we have to go for the end. Okay, what will be the end? More configuration. T as well as? Okay, so, and there you will commit the mistake. In the examination also and in the class also, the mistake will be in submitting the T and phi configuration. What is the T configuration first of all? After evaluating L and C, now you have to submit the T configuration. So the T configuration for an M denied low pass filter will consisting of first of all the series arm consisting of what? An inductor value ML/2. What is that? 0.0436 multiplied by L/2. Tell me what result you are getting. M is 0.436. L is 318.3 divided by 2. This is your M L/2, and this you have to substitute it. It will come out to be 69.4 millihenry. Is it clear? There will be another series branch here which is consisting of 69.4 millihenry. But there will be a shunt branch which is consisting of two components. One will be inductor, another will be capacitor. The value of the capacitor is how much? M multiplied by C. M is 0, so will be equal to 0.436 multiplied by how much? 0.171 microfarad. So how much it comes out to be? How much it comes out to be? 0.393. And when you multiply 0.393, it will come out to be 0.171 microfarad. Now, what is the value of inductor? 1 minus M square upon 4M. Just substitute all those values, and ultimately you will get it is 147.813. So this is the end result for T configuration. Now you have to submit a phi configuration also. Is it clear? So what will be in the phi? What will be the configuration of phi? There will be two shunt branches consisting of twice Z2 dash. And Z2 is how much?
Z2 by M.
Mind it. Is it clear? And what is Z2? What is Z2? 1/0 C. Is it clear? So it is became how much? MC by 2. Evaluate MC by 2.
0.0856.
How much you are committing?
0.0856.
Yes, 0.0856 microfarad. So the same thing, the another capacitor there on this side value 0.0856 microfarad. Now what happens? The series branch consisting of two parallel branches. One will be inductor and another will be a capacitor. Do you agree? Okay. What is the value of inductor? Z1 by M. You are MZ1. Multiply by this so-called 318 by 5. 0.3 million. How much it comes out to be?
138.6
million. Yes, 138.6 million. What about the capacitor? How much it was Z2? Z2 was 4M upon 1 minus M square. So it will become 1 minus M square C upon 4M. Evaluate it. It will come out to be 0.182 micro.
Yes.
Do you agree or not?
Yes,
so this is the end result you have to submit it. You join these two configurations and clear? So in the examination, the typical examiner is here, he will always ask where we have both the prototype formula as well as M derived. Is that any problem? That's all for today. In the next class tomorrow, we will go for high pass and bad pass.